Hello students, today we are going to see term 3 standard 4 English unit 2. In this unit 2 we are going to see about whom. The topic is the painter. Come, let's move on to the video session.
Unit 2, poem, the painter. In this poem we are going to learn the talent of the girl, that she was physically challenged. Even though she doesn't stop her hard work and challenge. Let me see the poem lines. Sitting on the cold mud floor, she paints the valley and hill, giving life to the canvas shore. Sees the brush bend her will. Once again I read the poem lines. Sitting on the cold mud floor, she paints the valley and hill, giving life to the canvas shore. Sees the brush bend to her will. The girl is sitting on the cold mud floor and she paints the hill and valley. Shore means seashore, but in this place the canvas should be bordered and pinned on the shore. Her brush was curved according to her wish. Here, will refers to her wish. Sitting on the cold mud floor, she paints the valley and hill, giving life to the canvas shore, sees the brush bend to her will. In this first stanza, floor, shore is a rhyming word and hill, will is a rhyming word. Her canvas used to be colorless until she learned that her brush strokes are not always aimless. The flow of paint never chokes. Her canvas used to be colorless until she learned that her brush strokes are not always aimless. The flow of paint never chokes. Her canvas, that is the drawing sheet, used to be colorless until she want to learn the brush stroke. Stroke means gentle movement. She was not stopped her try and the flow of paint on the board. Chokes means stopped. Her canvas used to be colorless until she learned that her brush strokes are not always aimless. The flow of paint never chokes. In the second stanza, colorless and aimless is the rhyming word and strokes and chokes is the rhyming words. She dips her brush to draw the big black panther. Her legs never in a rush. She moves them like a dancer. She dips her brush to draw a big black panther. Her legs never in a rush. She moves them like a dancer. She put her brush to draw a big black panther. Her legs were not in hurry. She did gentle movement to draw the painting. She moves her legs like a dancer. She dips her brush to draw the big black panther. Her legs never in a rush. She moves them like a dancer. In this third stanza, brush and rush is the rhyming word and panther and dancer is the another rhyming word. In this poem, the poet exposed the self-confidence of the girl by doing the painting. Let me see some glossary part. Bend, shape into a curve. Strokes, gentle movement of hand. Chokes, stops. Dip, put something in liquid. Now we are going to study about the grammar part. The rabbit has long ears. The word long tells What kind of ears the rabbit has? Long describes the rabbit's ears. The house is green. The word green tells us the color of the house. Green describes the house's color. Kasturi has three colorful balloons. Three and colorful tells us more about noun balloon. Three describes number and colorful describes quality. Adjectives. Words that describe noun are called adjectives. Adjectives give more detail about the noun's size, shape, color, and count. Match the adjectives with the appropriate picture. Brave lion, shady tree, long snake, spicy dish, sweet sugar cane, fast car. In the above given pictures, the words that describes noun, these are adjectives. Use the picture and the words to write the adjective. The giraffe is tall. Its neck is long. Its eyes are round. Its skin is yellow. Its tail is short. The words long, round, short, yellow, tall are the describing words for giraffe, that is noun. So these words are adjectives. There are three birds. The bird's feather is very soft. The color of the birds is blue. It is small in size. The babies are hungry. The words soft, small, blue, three, hungry are the describing words of a bird, that is noun. So these words are adjectives. Use adjectives you think for each of these words. You can write more than one adjectives. Here in the box, so many describing words are given. We have to choose and put for the reliable sentences. A clever boy, a stormy wind, a beautiful flower, a honest friend, a bright sun. Match each sentence to the correct picture by writing the number in the box. Here four sentences are given and four pictures are given. It was shuffled. We have to match the pictures according to the sentences. A brown and white puppy is having fun. Wild animals are in the thick forest. A cute boy is painting with green color. A naughty boy is riding horse with a sleepy dog. So first picture number 3. A cute boy is painting with green color. Second picture is 4. A naughty boy is riding horse with a sleepy dog. Third is 1. A brown and white puppy is having fun. Second one, wild animals are in the thick forest. So we have to number these sentences according to the pictures.